वक्रतुंड महाकाय सूर्यकोटिसमप्रभ निर्विघ्नं कुरु मे देव सर्वकार्येषु सर्वदा सरस्वती नमस्तुभ्यं वरदे कामरूपिणी उद्यारंभं करिष्यामि सिद्धिर्भवतु मे सदा गुरवे सर्वलोकानां ऋषये भवरोगिणां विधये सर्वविद्यानां दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्तिभेदविभागिने व्योमवद्व्याप्तदेहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः नारायणं पद्मभुवं वसिष्ठं शक्तिं च तत्पुत्रपराशरं च व्यासं शुकं गौडपदं महान्तं गोविन्दयोगीन्द्रमथास्य शिष्यं श्रीशङ्कराचार्यमथास्य पद्मपादं च अष्टामलकं च शिष्यं तं तोटकं वार्तिककारमन्यान् अस्मद्गुरून् सन्ततमानतोऽस्मि सदाशिवसमारम्भां शङ्कराचार्यमध्यमाम् अस्मदाचार्यपर्यन्तां वन्दे गुरुपरम्पराम् शङ्करं शङ्कराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्रभाष्यकृतौ वन्दे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः श्रुतिस्मृतिपुराणानाम् आलयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शङ्करं लोकशङ्करं साक्षात्कृतं दयानन्दं परमार्थस्वरूपिणं तत्त्वज्ञानप्रशास्तारं प्रणतोऽस्मि परं पदम् ॐ सहनाभवतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै ॐ शान्तिश्शान्तिश्शान्ति भद्रं कर्णेभिश्रुणुयामदेवाः भद्रं पश्येमाक्षभिर्यजत्राः स्थिरैरङ्गैस्तुष्टुवागुंसस्तनुभिः व्यशेमदेवहितं यदायुः स्वस्ति न इन्द्रो वृद्धश्रवाः स्वस्ति नः पूषा विश्ववेदाः स्वस्ति नस्तार्क्ष्यो अरिष्टनेमिः स्वस्ति नो बृहस्पतिर्दधातु ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। Can repeat. Om Brahma Devanam Pratamas Sambhubha.
Om Brahma Devanam Pratamas Sambhubha.
Vishvasya Karta Bhuvanasya Gupta. Sabrahma Vidyam Sarva Vidya Pratishtam. अथर्वाय ज्येष्ठपुत्राय प्राह अथर्वणेयां प्रवदेत ब्रह्मा अथर्वातापूर्ववाचाङ्गिरे ब्रह्म विद्याम् सभारद्वाजाय सत्यवहाय प्राह भारद्वाजे भारद्वाजो गिरसे परावराम् महाशालः अङ्गिरसं विधिवदुपसन्नः पप्रच्छ कस्मिन्नु भगवो विज्ञाते सर्वमिदं विज्ञातं भवति इति Can you mute your mic now? We are looking into this mantra, third mantra. Shaunakaha. Shaunakaha Mahashalaha. Shaunakaha Mahashalaha. Mahashalaha means he is a Maha Grihastha. Shaunaka, the disciple, Shishya, who is a Mahashalaha, a great householder, who is running a huge shala, Yajna shala, Paka shala, etc. He approached the teacher Angiras and asked, Paprachya, Vidivat Upasannaha, Paprachya. Mahashalaha indicates that the Shishya is a Grihastha. He belongs to the Grihastha Ashrama. Ashrama. Ashrama means the stage of life. We have four stages of life. Student life, Brahmacharya Ashrama, Grihastha Ashrama, then Vanaprastha, and then Sannyasa Ashrama. So he is in the second stage of life. Grihastha Ashramaha. Ashrama is Shastrokta Dharma Visheshaha Ashramaha. The word Ashrama, it comes from the Dhatu, Shram Dhatu. Shram. Ashramyati Svam Svam Tapaha Charanti Atra Asmin Saha Ashramaha. There one has to put effort. Shrama means effort. So that, in that, the stage of life, one has to put effort. And Svam Svam Tapaha Charanti. One has to do the duty that is a tapas. So that Chaturvidaha Bhavati Ashramaha Brahmacharya Grihastha Vanaprastha Sannyasa Iti. But in Kali Yuga, Kali Yuga Tu Brahmacharya Vanaprasthe Nastaha. Kevalam Grihastha Sannyasa Ashramau Eva. Grihastha Bhikshuka Ashramau Eva. Iti Mahan Nirvana Tantraha. Mahanirvana Tantre Uktam. Mahanirvana Tantra, it says in Kali Yuga, there are only two ashramas, Brahmacharya and Vanaprastha, not there. Only two ashramas, Grihastha and Sannyasa ashrama. Gargastho Baikshukaschaiva ashrama, though Kalo Yuge, na, not there. Gargastho Baikshika ashrama Kali Yuge Asti Staha. Only these two ashramas are there. That is Gargastha, Grihastha ashrama and Sannyasa ashrama. Gargastha Baikshukascha ashramaha eva ashramau, go ashramau eva Kali Yuge Staha. Brahmachari, Brahmacharya ashrama and Vanaprastha ashrama not there. Iti Mahanirvana Tantra, it says. Anyway, but in those days, the four ashramas were there, according to the Vedic scheme of life. And this Shaunaka, it belongs to the second stage of life. Now he wants to study Vedanta. Probably want to go to Vanaprastha and then Sannyasa Ashrama. So he is preparing himself for that. He has prepared sufficiently for that. That is indicated by the word Mahashalaha. He has done a lot of Karma Yoga, Panchamaha Yajna and Karma Yoga, and got the sufficient preparedness, the maturity. Therefore, approach teacher Vidivat. The word Vidivat is an important word. Vidivat, in keeping with the Shastram, Ita Shastram, in keeping with the rule, the protocol as prescribed by the Shastram. Here, this Vidivat, here a doubt is answered, a possible doubt is answered with regard to the word Vidivat. Why it is mentioned Vidivat here? Why it is not mentioned before? The other Shishya who preceded Shaunaka in the Parampara, didn't they approach the teacher Vidivat? Did this protocol, this Vidivat, the rule came into existence only after Shaunaka? Such a possible doubt is there. So therefore, that is answered. That is answered by the Ribhashyakara. So Bhashyakara gives two possible answers. One answer is that this rule was not followed by the Purva Acharyas. Atharva, Angir, Satyavaha, Angiras, up to that. This rule was not there. Not there, and therefore they did not follow. That is one possibility. From Shaunaka only this Vidivat came into vogue. That is one possible. Therefore, Shaunaka becomes the border, the maryada. Shaunaka is exempted from not following Vidivat. It means he must follow. From Shaunaka onwards, the rule is applicable. Before Shaunaka, it was not. Purvesham, it is not applicable. This is one answer. The second answer, that seems to be the best one, that is Shaunaka being a disciple, the Shishya, he represents disciples in general. Therefore, since he approached Angiras Vidivat, therefore Shaunaka stands for the protocol of the Shishya in general approaching the teacher. For that, Bhashyakara gives a maxim, a nyaya, madhya deepika nyaya. Madhya deepika nyaya, which says that a lamp placed between the two rooms, on the threshold between the two rooms, it lights up both the rooms. Similarly, by mentioning Vidivat to Shaunaka, we can extend this vidhi to the Purva, to the Purva Shishya, and also the Shishya who will be coming later. And therefore, it is applicable all the more to us. Asmadadishu api upasadana videhe ishtatvat iti Vashyakara says. That is the importance of the word vidhi, which Vashyakara had analyzed and which we have studied in the previous class. Now then, Shaunaka, he asked the teacher, paprachya, asked. It's a very loaded question. Tasminna bhagavo vijnate sarvamidam vijnatam bhavati iti. Before reading that question, let us read the Vashyam to this mantra from the beginning. You can repeat. Shaunakaha.
Shaunakaha.
Shaunakasya apatyam.
भारद्वाज
शिष्यम् आचार्यम् विधिवत यथाशास्त्रम् इत्येतत् उपसन्नः उपगतः सन् पप्रच्छ पृष्टवान् शौनक अङ्गिरसोः संबंधात अर्वाक विधिवत विशेषणात उपसदन विधेहे पूर्वेषां अनियमः इति गम्यते मर्यादाकरणार्थम् मध्यदीपिका न्यायार्थम् वा विशेषणम् अस्मदादिषु अपि उपसदन विधेहे इष्टत्वात् Up to this we have seen. Now, the next line of the Bhashyam we can read. Kim iti aha.
Kim iti aha.
Kasmin bhagavo vijnate.
Kasmin bhagavo vijnate.
Nu iti vitarke.
नो इति इतर्के इति इतर्के
भगवो हे भगवन्
भगवो हे भगवन्
सर्वं यत् इदं विज्ञेयं विज्ञातम्
सर्वं यत् इदं विज्ञेयं विज्ञातम्
विशेषेण ज्ञातम् अवगतम्
विशेषेण ज्ञातम्
अवगतम् भवति इति
भवति इति
एकस्मिन् ज्ञाते
एकस्मिन् ज्ञाते
सर्वविद् भवति इति
सर्वविद् भवति इति
शिष्टप्रवादं श्रुतवान् शौनकः
शिष्टप्रवादं
श्रुतवान् शौनकः Shaunakaha, not Shaunakaha. It's a typo. It is Shaunakaha. Okay. So, now, the Shishya, the Shaunaka, he approaches the teacher. Approach the teacher and ask this question. Kasminnu bhagavo vijnate sarvamidam vijnatam bhavati. Knowing one thing, everything else is this known. Is this question tenable? is this question tenable? By knowing one thing, we don't know anything else. In general, knowing one thing, we know only that particular thing. Therefore, is this question on the part of the Shaunaka, is it tenable? So therefore, for that, the possible answer could be, either Shaunaka must have heard about the existence of such a thing from the words of the Shishta Purusha, Shishta Pravadam, from the arguments of the Shishta Purusha, the exalted people. Probably you would have heard. And since already he was a Karma Yogi, preparing for Jnana Yoga and therefore Jnanam, therefore he was interested and he would have got some inkling of the words of the Shastram, Upanishad. The words, the vakyams of the Upanishad like Brahmavita apnoti param. Brahmavita, the knower of Brahma. The knower of Brahma. Apnoti, gains. Param, gains that. Param is that which is limitless, which is not bound, which is free. Knowing that, he gains that limitlessness. How can you gain the limitlessness? Apnoti is not physical gaining. Ap means to gain. Ap dhatu. Ap means to gain, to reach. Reaching is not by traveling. There is no physical traveling involved to reach. Reaching is in terms of gaining cognitively. It is gaining cognitively, understanding. Reaching is understanding. Getting, attaining, it means understanding. In English also, we have that phrase, we use that phrase. Did you get it? It means, do you understand? The same, apnoti. Apnoti means, it is avagacchati. Brahmavita, the knower of Brahma, param avagacchati, understands. So the knower of Brahma, param apnoti, he understands and therefore he gains that limitless. Understanding that limitless to be oneself, that is freedom, that is moksha. So therefore, you would have heard such words. Brahma with knowing Brahma. So therefore, he puts a question. To know that one. So he wants to know that one. Knowing which? That which is to be known. That which is to be known is known. Knowing which? Everything else is known. So therefore, knowing Brahma, that is the cause of everything which is Brahma, knowing that, the Swarupa, the nature of the cause, if it is known, then the Swarupa of the Karyam, the effects, is as well known. If you want to know a thing, you know the effect, you know the cause. That is how we approach. Our approach is, we are trying to know the effect so that we will know the cause. But Shastram says, know the cause, you will know the, you know all the effects. Karana jnanena karya jnanam bhavati. And if karyam is variegated, it is, there are many. If you know the karanam, then karya jnanam bhavati. You know, you gain the knowledge of the effects, because the effects are not separate from the karanam. This is the karya karana prakriya. Karanam is known, then karyam is known. All, and the karyam being many, the effects being many. If you know one thing, therefore many things, there are many effects, many products are known. Like if you know clay, then what is known? All the products of clay are known. Similarly, if you know Brahma, this prapancha, this jagat, which is the karya of Brahma, and this prapancha, which consists of chara and achara and so many other things, they are all the karya of Brahma, Ishvara. If you know Ishvara, then the effect, which is this is jagat, is as well known. So therefore, Shonaka has this question. Eka vijnanena sarva vijnanam bhavati. Bhavati va? That is a question. Is it so? This question itself implies that Shonaka is an informed person. The question is not a samanya prashna. It is a vishesha prashna. Because it is a vishesha prashna, it is a particular question. Therefore, Shonaka must have had general knowledge. General knowledge about the thing what he asks. Samanya jnanam. Samanya jnanam precedes the vishesha prashna. The samanya jnanam he gained because of association with Shishta Purushas, the great people. Therefore, he has the vishesha prashna. Samanya jnanam precedes vishesha prashna. Now he wants to gain vishesha jnanam, particular knowledge. Therefore, he has the vishesha prashna. Kasmin bhagavo vijnate iti. And he is asking, Kasmin bhagavo vijnate, which is there in the mantra. And the question has got some doubt. In the mind of Shaunaka, there is a doubt. He is not sure because he had heard, but he had not verified the truth of the statements of what he had heard. Doubt is there. If doubt is not there, then question itself will not be there. So definitely, a doubt is there. Therefore, no. No stands for doubt. A doubt in the mind of Shaunaka. No iti vitarke. Vitarke is doubt. Samshayaha. So, no iti vitarke. No is an avyaya. But here this avyaya stands for vitarka. Vitarka means the doubt. The doubt in the mind of Shaunaka. Therefore, kasmin nu bhagavo. Bhagavo. The word bhagavo should be bhagavan. It is bhagavat shabda. Bhagavan bhagavanto. Bhagavantaha. Bhagavantam Bhagavanto Bhagavataha. And Sambodhana is a Bhagavan. Sambodhana Pratama is Pratama Vibhakti a Bhagavan. But the Upanishad uses Bhagavo. It is Chandasam. Vedika Prayoga. Veda Vedic usage. It's called Chandasam. If you find a word as though violating the rule of the grammar rule, Vyakrana, Niyama, then it is the privilege of the Shastram can use. That is called Chandasam. In fact, Vyakranam came into existence later. First Veda and then only Vyakranam. Therefore Veda need not follow the rules of the grammar. So Bhagavo is Chandasam. Chandas means Veda. So it is a Chandasam, Vaidika Prayoga, Vedic usage. So Bhagavo is equal to He Bhagavan. Vashikara says that Bhagavo is He Bhagavan. Then Sarvam Yat Idam Vigyayam Vigyatam Sheshena Nyatam Avagatam Bhavati Iti. Every word of the mantra is explained by the Vashikara. Sarvam idam, all this, vijnayam, which is to be known, all this which is to be known, vijnatam, well known, vijnatam, visheshena jnatam, yat sarvam, Yet idam vijnayam vijnatam visheshena अवगतम विज्ञातम इज इक्वल टू विशेषेण अवगतम वि उपसर्ग विशेषेण अवगतम इट इज वेल नोन विशेषेण ज्ञातम अवगतम ज्ञातम इज इक्वल टू अवगतम नोन अंडरस्टूड सो ऑन नोइंग विच एवरीथिंग सर्वम इदम विच इज टू बी नोन विज्ञेयम ऑन नोइंग विच एवरीथिंग इज Avagatam, well known. That is a question. That is, knowing the reality of one thing, the whole world is known. Knowing the reality of everything is understood, knowing one thing. Bhavati iti. It's a question. So is there a thing knowing which everything else becomes well known, understood? This is a question. Now Vashikara analyzes the question of the Shaunakar. The question comes from the Shishya. It means it has a basis. You have to analyze the question, whether it is a Samanya Prashna or Vishesha Prashna. And we have seen it is a Vishesha Prashna. Vishesha Prashna precedes Samanya Jnana. Therefore, Vashyakara here, he discusses two things, two bases for the question of Shaunakara. One is Shabda Bijam. His question is based on the words of the learned people. Shishta Pravadam. एकस्मिन् ज्ञाते सर्वविद् भवति इति शिष्टप्रवादं श्रुतवान् शौनकः सो शौनकः मस्ट हैव हर्ड श्रुतवान् ही हर्ड शिष्टस्य प्रवादं वद मीन्स टू स्पीक वद धातु प्रवादं मीन्स प्रकर्षेण वादं दैट इज द आर्ग्युमेंट्स द स्पीच So, Shishta Pravadam. So, therefore, Shaunaka must have heard these statements of the Shishta Purusha. Shishta Pravadam, Shrutavan, Shaunakaha. Therefore, because he has heard, therefore this question has come. So, therefore, Samanya Jnanam and Vishesha Jnanam. Samanya Jnanam is the basis for inquiry into gaining the Vishesha Jnanam. Shaunaka knows what it is, Vedanta, Upanishad, that Samanya Jnanam, that general knowledge he must have had. Now, he wants to know a specific thing, a desire, a particular desire is there. A particular desire about what the Upanishad says is there. Therefore, he has a question, that is Vishesha Prashna and out of Vishesha Prashna, he gains Vishesha Jnana, the detailed knowledge. So, therefore, Prashna Bija, and Prashna Bija is the words of the teachers, the words of the Shishta Purusha, the elderly people, the senior people, the exalted people who were there at that time. So, the words become the Bija, the seed for this Vishesha Prashna. Okay, then, so, therefore, the next line, you can read the next line. Tat Vishesham.
Vignyatu Kamahasan.
Kasminnu Iti. Vitarkayan Papracha. Okay. Vignyatu Kamaha. Vignyatum Kamaha Yasya Saha Vignyatu Kamaha. That is having the desire to know. Vignyatum Kamaha Yasya Saha. The one who has the desire to know. What? That Visheshyam specifically. Specifically, because he had Samanya Jnanam, therefore specific question is asked. Visheshan, tat visheshan, specifically paprachya is asked. Tat visheshan paprachya. Kaha vijnyatukamaha shonakaha. The shonaka who has a desire to know. He has a particular desire to know. General knowledge, yes. Now we want to gain specific knowledge, particular knowledge. Therefore, vijnyatukamaha san, being a vijnyatukamaha, the desirer to know. Tasminno iti vitarkayan paprachya. What is that? Kasmin. Knowing which, everything is as well known. Vitarkayan, assuming, doubting. He has got a doubt. Assuming. Because he has heard, therefore he assumes, he supposes the existence of a thing, knowing which everything else is known. Therefore, kasminnu iti. Kasminnu iti. It means you have to bring the question from the mantra. Kasminnu iti vijnate sarvamidam vijnatam bhavati iti. That iti stands for the whole, the question. Iti vitarkayan, doubting, paprachya. Kaha? Shaunakaha. So, this line says that this Vishesha Prashna precedes Samanya Jnanam. And the reason for Samanya Jnanam is Shishta Pravadam. This is one possibility for the question of Shaunaka. Then, the second possibility Bhashyakara gives that we can read. Atava. So Vashikara gives a second possible reason for this question. What is that? And before that, before analyzing the second possibility, this Shonaka asking this question, Ekasmin Vijnate, knowing one thing. Knowing one thing, everything is known. When we say, that is knowing one thing, everything. Knowing everything by knowing one thing. It is, if it is possible, this possibility, it is there only in the context of the Upanishads. Only in Vedanta, in Upanishads only it is possible. Why? Because Satya Vastu Ekam Brahma. There is only one Satya Vastu. And everything else is Mithya. Everything else depends on the Satya. Satya Vastu. Everything has existence on this Satya. Satya Vastu. It means everything else is Asat. And the Sat is Ekam Brahma. Ekam Brahma Sat. Anyata sarvam mithya asat. Asat doesn't have separate existence. Nasato vidyate bhavaha, nabhavo vidyate sataha. ubhayoropi drishtontaha tvanyo tattvadarshibhih. So therefore, if you know the satya vastu, then the mithya which is not separate from satya is as well known, because the other, the mithya, doesn't exist apart from satya. So therefore, Brahma is there, which is the karanam, and this jagat, which is referred to by the word idam sarvam means this jagat, and this jagat is a base for all our empirical transaction. It has got the vyavahara satta. Only vyavahara satta. And Brahma is paramarthika satta. If you say Brahma is satyam, one thing is satyam, and everything else is mithya, then they must belong to two different orders of reality. Brahma is paramarthika, and this jagat is vyavaharika. They cannot be on the same order of reality. If there is a sambandha, satya mithya relationship is there, then it is only possible when they belong to different orders of the reality. In the same order of reality, it is not possible. That is why knowing one thing, everything else is known. It is not possible in the Vyavaharika Prapancha. It is not possible. This is possible only if the Vyavaharika Prapancha as its Satta existence on the Paramarthika Vastu, which is Brahma. Because you don't see that in the Vyavaharika. And even though you do all the Vyavahara in the Jagat, it cannot make any dent on the Satya Vastu, Brahma. The Brahma, without undergoing any change, it has become the Jagat. It has not gone any change. Therefore, even the Karya Prapancha is nothing but Brahma only. Because Brahma, without growing any change, it appears as this Jagat. That's why we say Jagat is Mithya, doesn't have separate existence apart from Brahma, and Brahma is Satyam. The Satya Vastu, Brahma alone, appears as this Mithya Jagat. And this Mithya Jagat is available for the transaction. And this Mithya Jagat has its basis on Brahma. So therefore, Satyam and Mithya, these are belong to different orders of the reality. So therefore, if it is so, then Satyam is there, and this Mithya depends on Satya. So knowing Satya Brahma, then you can know this Mithya Prapancha. This is an Anuma, this is an Arthapatti. This Jagat, which is Mithya, and the Brahma, which is the Adhishtana, the Satya for this Mithya Jagat, this can be known through Arthapatti, provided if you know that Brahma is Satya. For that, Shruti is the Pramanam. So, therefore, Shaunaka must have inferred. It's a two-step inference, Arthapatti. You would have heard Brahma Satyam, Brahma Vita Apnoti Param, Ityadi Vakyam. So, therefore, Brahma Satyam is heard, and this Jagat is Mithya. And if there is a relationship, Satya Mithya relationship, then it must be of relationship of the two orders of reality. How can there be relationship between the two orders of reality? That relationship is also mithya. It means what is here is nothing but Brahma. What is here is Ishvara alone. The Ishvara, without undergoing any change, he has become this entire Jagat. So therefore, this presumption Shonaka must have got based on the statements of what he had heard from the Shishta Purushas. So therefore, this question, now it is based on the Anumana. So the seed for this question is Anumana, Anumana Bija. The previous it is Shabda Bija. In the first one, the possibility was Shabda Bija. That is, the Bija for asking this Vishesha Prashna is what he had heard from the Shishta Purushas. And now, the second possibility is the seed for this question must have been from is presumption. He would have applied his assumption, Anumana, and therefore he could have asked this question. The possibility is there. Therefore, in this, Bhashyakara suggests Anumana Pramana probably Shonaka would have handled. By Anumana, you would have asked this question. By Arthapati, Anumana. Arthapati is nothing but Anumana. It's a two-step inference. Therefore, Bhashyakara says here, Atava, or the second possibility, or Loka Samanya Drishtya. Loka Samanya Drishtya. From the general observation of the Loka, the world, the people of the world. Loka Samanya Drishtya, through that, Nyatva Papracha, having known the general vision of the people of the world, Shaunaka Papracha. Shaunaka asked. General observation of the world. What is that? Loke Santi. In the world, it is there. What is there? Suvarnadi Shakala Vedaha Santi. Suvarnadi Shakala Vedaha Santi. In the world, Suvarna Adi. Suvarna is gold. Shakala here is, Shakala is parts. Shakala is parts. Parts of gold means ornaments. The gold which are differentiated in terms of its parts, that is ornaments. Suvarnadi Shakala Vedaha Suvarnatvat. Suvarnatvat, from the Suvarna alone, from the gold alone. From the gold alone, Suvarnat, Suvarnat Ekatvena Vijnanena. This Suvarnadi Shakala Vedaha, this variety of pieces of the gold, that is the ornaments, that is the products, the karya, its karyas. Suvarnatvat ekatvena ekatva vijnanena. By the knowledge of the one gold, by knowledge of the oneness of gold, vijnaya manaha, are known. So, knowing the gold, all the pieces made of gold, that is the ornaments of gold, vijnayamanaha laukikaihi, are known by the common man, common people. So, suvarnatva ekatva vijnanena, by the knowledge of the oneness of gold, suvarnadi shakala vedaha vijnayamanaha. All the products of gold are known. Knowing the cause, the effects as well known. So gold is the cause, and the ornaments, abhushanas, which are made of gold, knowing gold, they are known. Knowing clay, the products of clay are known. Knowing water, all the products of water, foam, waves, bubbles, everything is nothing but Nama Rupa, everything else is known. This is a Loka Samanya Drishti. This is a general observation of the people in the world. So, therefore, Shaunaka would have extended this. Shaunaka would have extended this to here also, to this topic also. Therefore, he asked. Tatakimno asti sarvasya jagat vedasya ekam karanam it ekasmi vijnate sarvam vijnatam. Similarly, tata, similarly, is there anything? What is that? Kimno asti, kim asti, kimno asti. What is that? Or is it there? Is it there? Jagat vedasya, sarvasya jagat vedasya ekam karanam. This jagat, which has got Veda, the verities are there in the jagat. Sarvasya jagat vedasya ekam karanam. One cause for the verities of the things which are observed in the world. One cause. The effects are many, but cause is one. And that one cause, ekasmin, itu ekasmin, vijnate, knowing that one thing, sarvam vijnatam bhavati, everything becomes known. Sarvasya jagat vedasya ekam karanam. And that ekam karanam, itu ekasmin vijnate, knowing that one karanam, sarvam vijnatam bhavati. Iti, this is anumana bija. This question is based on the anumana. Because lokas samanya drishti is there, extending that to this topic of Upanishad also, Shaunaka could have asked, eka karana jnanena, aneka karya jnanam bhavati. That is known, very well known in the loka. It's a loka samanya drishti. Extending that, the same thing, probably Shaunaka could have asked this question. Therefore, this question is based on the anumana bija. So one is shabda bija, other one is anumana bija. So two possibilities, bhashyakara presence. So from this we understand this karya jagat, any karya cannot exist without the karanam. Karya doesn't exist without karanam. This is loka samanya drishti. Karya and karanam. Karya, karanam. In the loka, if it is there, then the change, the karya must have come from the karanam, undergoing some change. Parinama should have happened. From the karanam, the karya has come. It means the karanam must have undergone some change to become the karya. So a change, a parinama must have happened. Is it the same thing with regard to satya vastu brahma and this mithya jagat? The satya vastu brahma has undergone change to become this mithya brahma. If that is so, then the brahma is subject to change. It is Avikari Brahma. If Brahma has undergone a change to become the Jagat, then it will not be Brahma anymore. It will not be the limitless Brahma. Then it will not be limitless Brahma. Then what will be there? Brahma is not there. What is there is only Jagat. Jagat only will be there, and Jagat will be Satyam. And Jagat only will be Satyam. But that is not possible. That is not possible. Because Jagat being limited, how can the limitless Brahma can become Jagat? Therefore, that belongs to two different orders of reality. If it belongs to the same order of reality, then the Karanam can undergo Parinama to become the Karyam. But if it belongs to a different order of reality, then it must be a Vivarta. A Vivarta Brahma must be a Vivarta Upadana Karanam, as though the Brahma has become the Jagat. In reality, it did not. Brahman cannot undergo change to become the Jagat. The Jagat, what it appears, is only an appearance. That's why it is an appearance. It is an appearance. Brahma, without undergoing any change, it has become the Jagat. It means the Jagat is not different from Brahma. The Jagat is nothing but Brahma, Ishvara. So what is only Ishvara. This knowledge Shaunaka wants to gain. Therefore, he puts the question so nicely. And you may think, why the question is so profound, deep, that not only you, even the Purva Pakshi will ask the same question. Why this question? How can we understand this question? Therefore, Purva Pakshi now, he raises an objection. Akshepaha. Nanu.
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 Viditehi.
Viditehi.
Kasmin iti prashnaha anupapannaha.
Kasmin iti prashnaha anupapannaha.
So, Bhashyakara thinks, at every stage he will raise objection, he explains the possibility and required, raises objection and answers. He doesn't take things for granted. So here, through the mouth of Purva Pakshi, Bhashyakara asks this question. What question? Nanu. Nanu stands for objection. That is the words of the opponent. He says, Prashnaha Anupapannaha. This Prashna, Kasmin iti prashna, the question, it is not tenable. It is not proper, not tenable. Aviditehi. Aviditehi kasmin iti prashnaha anupapannaha. Avidite, not knowing. Not knowing that such a thing, knowing one thing, everything else is known. Not knowing that, this question, is there such a thing? Not knowing that one thing, knowing which everything else is known, not knowing that, asking the question, is there such a thing? Is it proper? Is it a proper question? Unless you establish the existence of that thing, knowing which everything else is known, unless you know that, or at least you have got some vague knowledge about that, you cannot ask this question, what is that? So, this question is not tenable. This question is not tenable. If at all if he asks this question, then he must know. Then why does he ask? If at all, if it is there, then he must know that. So, in the absence of knowing such a thing really exists, because question being a question, so therefore question is there means that when there is absence of knowledge, then only the question is asked. Nobody knowingly they will not ask any question. Want to know, therefore ask a question. So therefore here for Shaunaka, in the absence of knowing such a thing exists, asking this question, kasmin iti prashnaha anupapannaha, it is not tenable. Iti Purva Pakshi raises an objection. Then the next line we can read. Kim asti tat.
Kim asti tat.
Iti prashnaha yuktaha.
Iti prashnaha yuktaha.
Siddhehi astitve.
Siddhehi astitve.
Kasmin iti syat.
Kasmin iti
syat. Yata kasmin nideyam iti.
Yata kasmin nideyam iti.
This example I give the last class. Kim asti tat iti prashnaha yuktaha. Bhashyakara says, kim asti tat iti, kim asti tat iti tada prashnaha yuktaha. Siddhehi astitve kasmin iti syat, yata kasmin nideyam iti. So here, the Purva Pakshi says, Kim asti tat iti tada prashnaha yuktaha. This question, what is that? This question, it is valid. It is valid only when you know. Only when you establish the existence of such a thing, then only this question is yuktaha. It is tenable. Like सिद्धेहि अस्तित्वे कस्मिन् इति स्यात् यथा कस्मिन् निदेयम् इति. दैट इज इन अ याग देयर आर मेनी वेसल्स प्लेस्ड अराउंड द यागकुंड होमकुंड. नाउ इन विच वेसल द घी शुड बी पोर्ड. In which vessel the ghee must be poured? This question is a valid question because there are many vessels are there, and now the ghee is to be poured. Therefore, you can ask this question: in which vessel the ghee should be poured? So, kim asti tat, does that exist? This question is tenable only for the thing which is known. When the existence of a thing itself is not known, kim asti tat iti prashnah na yuktah, it is not proper, it is not reasonable. Only when established, siddehi eva, siddehi astitve siddehi eva, only when you establish the existence of such a thing, kasmin iti prashnah yuktah, kasmin, the question kasmin is tenable. Like in the vessel where the ghee should be poured, kasmin nideyam, many vessels are there, therefore in which vessel the ghee or water, maybe ghee or milk or water, which is to be placed, which is to be poured, nideyam iti. That prashnah is yuktah only when you establish the existence of vessels. Vessels are there that you see, so many vessels are there, many patrams are there. The patra samanya gyanam is there, patra samanya gyanam, general knowledge of the vessels are there, then only you can ask the question where these material should be, in which vessel the material should be poured. If you don't see any vessel there, then you want to pour the ghee or the water or milk, then what question you will ask? Question is not possible. Vessels are there, so the knowledge of the existence, pre-existence of the vessels are there, therefore kasmin nideyam iti prashnah yuktah. The same thing here also. So therefore, without establishing the existence of such a thing, without knowing, having a general idea about that a thing is there, without having that, how can this question be asked? This is the question of Purvapakshi. And Purvapakshi, he has a question with an example. Kasmin nideyam iti. Yata kasmin nideyam iti. For that, Vashikara, he answers, na.
Na.
First, he simply says, no, not like that. No. Further, he elaborates on that. Aksharabahulyat.
Aksharabahulyat.
Ayasabhirutvat.
Ayasabhirutvat.
Prashnah sambhavati eva.
सो
अक्षर बागुल्यात् आयास भीरत्वात् प्रश्नः संभवति एव. भाष्यकारः सेस् दिस् such question is tenable only, it is proper only. It is na when he says prashnah anupapannah iti na. You said prashnah anupapannah, Purvapakshi. It is not so. Prashnah anupapannah iti na. That is not correct. It means the question is correct. Why is it correct? Vashikara justifies. This is a vishesha prashna. This is a vishesha prashna. Vishesha prashna precedes samanya jnanam. Vishesha prashna precedes samanya jnanam. And therefore samanya prashna is implied. Samanya prashna, therefore samanya jnanam. It is implied. Therefore samanya jnanam asti eva. Samanya jnanam asti eva. So therefore here. Now this Shaunaka, the Shaunaka who has got this samanya jnanam, now he is asking that, goes to the teacher with Samitpanihi and Vidivat he goes to the teacher. When he goes to the teacher, he wants to gain knowledge. He wants to gain this Atmajnanam, Brahmajnanam. To gain that, to going to a teacher, how to present this? How to present this? You go to the teacher and you ask what you want in a word or two or in a simple sentence, or you will give your whole list of knowledge, what you have gained, your whole biography, and then ask the teacher. That is what generally people do. When you go to the teacher, guru, what you want to know, that to be precisely presented. But generally, even when asking question, first they will say whatever they know. They will go round and round. They give a long description of what they know, and also confirms whether teacher knows. And then finally, they ask, and before the teacher replies, the student thinks himself understands and goes away. This is how it happens. That is not done like that in the tradition. Really, if the students wants to know, the students will ask a simple question. A simple question implies so many things. From the way you present the question, the acharya will understand what you know and what you want to know, how much you know and what you want to know, and your intention, your commitment to know, your adhikaritam, everything can be inferred from the prashna. Therefore, the prashna is very important. How you present the question is very important. You present the question in a simple way using minimum number of words, and that gives a lot of information to the teacher. So there will not be any unnecessary dialogues between the teacher and the student in the beginning. What you want to know, you present that very precisely. So therefore, Vashikara says, Kasminnu ekasmin vijnate sarvavit syat. What is that one thing knowing which one become sarvavit, sarvajna, all knowing? Knowing one thing, you become all knowing. This prashna is sambhavati eva. It is tenable. Why? Because akshara bhagulyat ayasa bhirutvat. Shaunaka was so humble. Being a karma yogi, practiced values, so is very humble. He knows little. Out of humility, when humility is there, you will not give a long lecture. Even when asking question, you will use minimum number of words. Therefore, akshara bhagulyat, this question and the subsequent answer for that, akshara bhagulyat, the question you want to ask, and you have to use a number of words for that. It's a long, maybe a long sentence or more than one sentence or many sentences. So the Shaunaka, akshara bhagulya, he doesn't want to use many words to convey what he wants to know and what he knows also. And also he is bhirutvat, ayasa bhirutvat, to handle many words and many sentences, effort is involved, and therefore he is maybe afraid of presenting what he wants to know using a number of words and sentences. Therefore, akshara bhagulya. Bhagulya means abundance. Akshara is words. Therefore, akshara bhagulyat ayasa bhirutvat. Ayasa means effort. Effort is in the form of talking more, using more words, akshara bhagulya. So akshara bhagulya is the hetu for ayasa bhiru. Why ayasa bhiru? Why there is a fear of the effort? Because more words are involved. You want to present the question, and the question involves more number of words in general. So he is afraid of handling many words. And handling many words has got ayasa, the effort. Therefore, he was concerned. And also, when you talk when you go and approach the teacher, talk to the teacher, you should present your question in a simple way using minimum words, and your and the question must be very clear. There should be brevity in your presentation of the question. You should have thought about the question very well before asking. It should be a well formulated question, prashna. All these things you have to plan and then only ask. Because you want to ask something and you will ask, end up asking something because you don't know how to present the question, and it involves a lot of words. So, and words, handling words, effort is involved. Therefore, ayasa bhiruhu asti, ayasa bhirutvat, and ayasa, for ayasa bhiru, the hetu, the causes, akshara bhagulya. So, tasmat, therefore, Shaunaka, being an humble student, since he knows that lot of words are involved and it takes effort to present, so he puts the question in a way, a simple way. It's a well, very well formulated question. Therefore, this question is sambhavatiyeva. This is possible. This question is tenable only. The Vashikara dismisses Purvapakshi. Then, now the Shaunaka has the question, and the teacher is understands Shaunaka, what he knows and what he wants to know also. But the teacher, even though he knows what Shaunaka knows, but the teacher doesn't start from where he knows. It starts from before. It means what Shaunaka knows, that also he covers. He gives, that is the teaching. What Shaunaka knows, that also he covers, and what he wants to know, that also he will cover. That is the daya, the compassion of the teacher. And the Shaunaka is afraid of presenting the question, and therefore he presents the question using minimum number of words. But the teacher, Angiras, is so compassionate, he understands the student, and therefore he answers the question of the student from where what he knows to what he wants to know. He covers both so that the knowledge will be very clear. That is the daya, the compassion of the acharya. And now the acharya, the Angiras, he answers. From here onwards, the teaching starts. Now Angiras, the Shaunaka has asked. Now Angiras will start speaking. He will present the Upadesha. The teaching starts from this mantra onwards up to the end of the Upanishad. It will be only the Upadesha of the teacher Angiras. Now the Angiras, he answers. We will read the mantra and we will see the meaning in the next class. Tasmai Saho Vacha.
Tasmai Saho Vacha.
Ve Vidye Veditavye. यद्ब्रह्मविदो वदन्ति परा चैव परा च यू कैन सी द कनेक्शन बिटवीन द आंसर एंड द क्वेश्चन देयर इज नो कनेक्शन रियली. Shaunaka asks, what is that one thing knowing which everything is known? And the teacher says, there are two knowledges. One is paravidya, other one is aparavidya. That is not the answer. But the teacher starts instructing, starts giving upadesha from what Shaunaka knows. From there onwards, he starts. We'll see. We'll see the meaning of the mantra and the Vashyam in the next class. Let's stop here. Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnamevavashishyate Om Shanti Shanti Shantih. Harihi Om Shri Gurubhyo Namah.
Harihi Om. धन्यवाद है गुरुजी.
धन्यवाद गुरुजी. धन्यवाद जी.
धन्यवाद जी.